extensive overhaul by the National Park Service brought together descendants of both General Lee and enslaved people who once lived and labored on his estate. Only on CBS This Morning, Jerika Duncan, there she is, was there when they met up in person for the very first time. Jerika, good to see you in the studio. What was it like?
Always good to see you, too. It was incredible. It was a remarkable moment, nearly 200 years in the making. Now the families have found common ground, all hoping to tell a more complete story of a place with a very complicated history. The crown that sits atop the hallowed ground of Arlington National Cemetery is this mansion. It has a commanding view of our nation's capital and was once home to General Robert E. Lee. But to get here required taking many steps forward.
It's Steve
on the
there.
Left, that's Robert E. Lee the V, walking for the first time with descendants of others who also once lived here, the enslaved. When you come here, how do you feel?
I get a connection.
I think about the people who actually helped to build it.
Inez Parks and Steve Hammond have roots at this historic site. Inez's great-grandfather, James Parks, dug the first graves at Arlington.
They're the people, a deserving people. They need their story told.
In new exhibits opening today, the lives of Parks and those who labored for free are now a greater focus at this national memorial. The Park Service restored these former slave quarters that had become the site's bookstore.
The fact that we have chosen to change it back into a place of honor, I think, is a very big deal.
Aaron LaRocca is with the National Park Service.
Could you have imagined a day like this 15 years ago when you first started?
No, we've really been able to progress, to uplift the story of all the people here.
A story Steve Hammond and his family have spent years unraveling.
Robert E. Lee ultimately signs a deed to free 40 people that were enslaved here, and Charles Syphax is one of those.
Hammond learned that General Lee freed his relative, Charles Syphax, and dozens of other enslaved people.
The stories are very complex, and they're, I think, worth the country knowing more about.
Rob Lee and his sister, Tracy Lee Crittenberger, agree. They're the general's great-great-grandchildren.
You are Robert E. Lee V, and I have a feeling you might have a son.
I think you're right.
With the same name.
Yes.
While the family has kept the name alive, they've worked to bury the ideals associated with it. After seeing the images from Charlottesville in 2017, last summer's global reckoning on racial injustice, and watching statues of General Lee come down, his family spoke up.
What was that conversation like within your family?
I think it was really, all of those things need to happen.
As a Lee family, we stand completely in alignment with the social justices that are going on today. There's no chance that we're going to be the leaders of this. But if we can do one small thing here, it's just to say we want to move forward.
So does billionaire philanthropist David Rubenstein. He donated more than $12 million toward the National Park Service's restoration project and wants to remove Robert E. Lee's name.
Why fight so hard to make that change?
Well, I think that Robert E. Lee is a person who symbolizes for some people things that probably are not appropriate.
But renaming the memorial would take an act of Congress.
Drop the Robert E. Lee name from it, but it doesn't expunge his history here.
It's not just about General Lee. It's about all the families that lived here and all their voices.
The women's voices, the children's voices.
Generations later, families connected by a painful past freed the untold stories to honor the people who made this a national treasure.
I get emotional talking about it. It's a very powerful opportunity to bring people together and try to make a difference in a better world.
Is it fair to say that you dreamed of this moment?
Absolutely. I have been looking forward to this for years.
Well, the Park Service site, as we mentioned, reopens today, and those conversations between the families, as you can imagine, continue. At the end of the day, details matter.
Yes.
And knowing your history matters, but more importantly, they were able to tell the stories of people who had a great contribution there that really weren't told in this way before.
Facts matter even when the facts are very uncomfortable. It's very interesting to see the Lee family, though, Robert E. Lee,
yes,
saying, yeah, we believe it's time.
I love that they took the bookstore and were
slave quarters so people could see the structure that was there and how they lived.
Exactly. Very powerful piece, Rita. Thank you. Tomorrow, our